smile when I pulled up. I can pretty well read your mind. Well, she's heard it all most of her life.
Good morning, guys. It is currently 11:12 in the morning, and as you can see, I'm not sitting in just any ordinary S10. I am sitting in an Audi Q7. Obviously can't start it up. I wish we could. I guess the blinkers work. This is a pretty nice car. Get you a little storage component there. We're at Carmax here in Jackson, Tennessee. But however, we can look at it. Here's the sticker. I don't know if you can see it. Oh, there's the sticker. Oh shoot. Okay.
Oops.
Yeah, these back seats been used quite a bit. Here's the back of it. You got these buttons right here. That's pretty neat, ain't it? Got something down here. Now, some of these cars, you can actually start the radio by hitting a simple power button. Looky there. I don't know if it's touchscreen. Nope. Oh, that's how you do it. Or you can do it. Oh, that ain't working. There's also, yeah, see, I'm hitting this button right here. There's actually a way. Oh, right here. That's a good sound system. There it goes. Let's look at the hood. Under the hood, rather. Oh, this one actually has a latch. It's a big old V6, I do believe. See there, I think it's a V6. Right here's some more, another sticker. What does Carmax say? Nope, it's a 4-cylinder 2.0. 4-cylinder, really. But yeah. Now we're going to move on to the next car, which is a 2020 Volvo XC90 T5 Momentum. 39,000 miles. Looks pretty cool. I don't know, obviously can't start it. I don't know why I tried that. Oh, no, right here it is. With this nice grain wood. I think they had this here last time I was here. I don't know how close back that car is, but look at this nice stuff. Where's the hood release? Somewhere's the hood release. I think this is, that's definitely not it.
Oh, if I could find the hood release, there it is. Look at that.
Tells you when the hood's open.
But here's the sticker. Back seat. Yeah, see how close it is to this Highlander. Eh, not too close. But this is how it is back here. You got your little spare tire and stuff. Go take a look underneath the hood. You also got your blind spots right here. See what she hay is. There's the hood, at least. I can. There it goes. For y'all's Volvo lovers. I don't know what size it is. I think it's a V6. Sound about right? They said this is also a 4-cylinder. But yeah. Anyway. Let's see what else I got in store for us. What about a 2021 Ford F-150 XL? This one is just pretty much basic. It don't really have any of the fancy features. It has, you got your 12 volt, all that crap. What's this button do? Oh, got your little compartment right there. Got your screen here. Obviously, with this being base model, you're gonna have a key. I think it's actually dead. I'm assuming probably gonna be your 5.0 liter. Probably. See, the keys are in those, and they won't really let you get the key out unless you're gonna buy it or something. I don't really know how many miles is on here. Here's the window sticker. It says 11,000 miles. Your bed. Nope. Here's the sticker. Looks like it's a V6. See, there's one. There's three cylinders on this side. Three on this side's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Yeah, it's a V6. Nope, not a 4.0. But yeah, there's here an F-150. Here's what the passenger side looks like. Seats are pretty comfortable. Anyway, on to the next one. Here we got a 2019 Dodge Ram Rebel. I don't know much about these trucks. I really don't. This one says it has 33,000 miles and it's a 5.7 liter. This looks nice. On it. Uh-oh. I think it might be dead too. Oh, let's get in here. Obviously can't start it. But yeah, this interior looks nice. You got a rim and bolster right there. Yeah, it's dead. The four-ways don't even work. This is one thing I do not like that Ford, that Dodge has, is that. Oh, you got your little hiding compartment. Yeah, like I said, I don't know much about these Dodge. Right there. Go see this 5.7 and then we'll move on to the next vehicle on the list. which will be a sedan. Yep, 5.7 Hemi. Okay, let's go to the next vehicle. Okay guys, what about a 17 C300? Oh gosh, dog. Yeah, trying to get this thing. Oh, okay. Anyway, this is a nice little C300. It's a four cylinder. They've actually had this out here for quite some time. Like I said, it's a little four cylinder. Has a panoramic sunroof. See? Unfortunately, it don't have an automatic tail release deal. It has your typical Mercedes blind spot and all that crap. Well, all that good stuff, not crap, but. Now the hood release is somewhere. I think I'm on it. Yep. Yeah, it's just a typical four cylinder. Right there's your little badge. I think this will be a good thumbnail. Alrighty. Had to get a picture. Now let's go to this car, which is a Cadillac. CT5 Sport. Oh. Right here is the door handle release that's behind here. What if it gets the... Nope. Electric doors. Oh! Good lord. That was a drop. Sorry, I gotta adjust the seat. But this looks pretty nice. For a Cadillac, get your wireless phone charger right here. I got power. I wonder if the radio works. It does. I think this is a premium sound. Let's see here.
UHFZ guns. The old, the odd, the curious, and new stuff.
Oh, hang on. It sounds like a General Motor type deal. Let's take a peek underneath the hood here. Oh gosh, the car sits low, guys. Has your panoramic sunroof on it. It has 40,000 miles on it, I'm assuming. There's your back little back seat. In your trunk. Yeah, let's take a peek underneath the hood. I know this video is not recording upside down. Yep, get your turbo and it is recording upside down. That's okay. I'm sure the editor can fix it soon. Anyway, let's go on to the next one. Which is a 2017 Audi A4 Premium. See? Low mileage. Ooh, obviously low to the ground. Good grief. Very comfortable. I don't think I get used to this little steering wheel though. You got your little, your sunroof. Let's see about the radio. Nothing. Oh, there you go. Look at there. Is it gonna come on? I guess not. Well. Okay. Nope. Go back. Okay, let's turn it off then. Anyway, I'm assuming your little cubby there. Where's the trunk really? Oh, right here. Get out and your back seat here. Got your a lot of trunk space in there. Oh God, that hood's heavy. I believe that's a four cylinder. But anyway, move on to this Audi, which is a 2018 5 Premium. More miles than that one. It's a coupe. See how a coupe looks? Looks pretty much the same. It is. So we won't spend much time on this one. Let me walk around, see if I can find something else. What about a 2014 Dodge Charger SE? Has 115,000 miles on it. Looks pretty good. That sounds funny. You got your little start button here. I don't think it will read. Let me look. Nope. It's in that little box right there. I wonder if the radio works. Nope. Anyway, it's a pretty nice little car. We got down here. You got your, got an aux and USB, and a 12 volt deal in it. This was pretty good. I think it has the V6 in it, I believe. That and a trunk. Yeah, I believe it has a V6 in it. Which is a 3.7 or 3.6. Let me see here. I think it's a V6. Yeah, it's a V6. It's a V6. Look right here. Pretty considerable trunk space. Did I already open this back door for y'all? For the back seat? I don't know. I just like sitting in this front seat right here. I really do. I ain't lying. I mean, look at this. This is how they looked back in 2014 on the cluster. I wish I could start it, but I guess there is nothing else to show you, so I'm going to end this right here. It is very cold, or we'd still continue looking around at cars. But if you like this little segment, leave a comment of what you think, and I will see what else I can show you. It lit up again. What I can show you
very soon. We'll be back.
Hope y'all really enjoyed that content. I froze my fingers off and some of them hoods were very heavy. But now we are back home. I done ate lunch and now we're taking the trash to the dump. And then I gotta run and fuel up the truck. And I guess that will be that. Okay. Now, let's get out of Dodge and go get this truck ready for the week. Anyway, we're gonna pull in here and really. Don't look at me, look at you. Anyhow, people think they have the rights. Let's get gas and be right back. So that was a total of $39.52. And gas is like two something for gas. Anyway, truck is all gassed up for the week because the truck is getting the weekend off. She needs it, so she's gonna get it. She does. This truck deserves a well-needed break. So we'll just find something this weekend to do around the house. Just find something for the weekend.
Broadcasting from the Hiller Plumbing, Heating, Cooling, and Electrical Studios. Free service call with any.
Why is this dude trying to race? He literally was. to pull up here to Dollar Store. We're gonna park right here where I usually park at, just right here, and I'll be right back. Oh boy, I wish this weather would make up its mind. I got some, I went to Walmart and I picked something up, which I think is pretty neat. It's a little air freshener deal that automatically sprays. I think I got it set for like every 18 minutes. It'll let out a fragrance spray. So I went here to see if they had anything for it, which they did. So I got a can of it. I don't know what it's called though. It's called Aqua Waves, is what we got. I'll show y'all when we get to the house what it looks like. I think it's pretty neat. I don't know if the videos are going to be short this weekend or if they're going to be, I don't know. We might even detail the truck on the inside. Yeah, I think we'll do that. Truck needs a cleaning on the inside, a good cleaning too. The RAV4 does too, so we might do the truck one day and the RAV4 the next. I don't know what we're gonna do. All I know is I'm not going nowhere.
Pictures on her phone and tears in her eyes. Waterproof makeup ain't made for a breakup on a Saturday night. Then it's, hey, how you been?